waking up. Pick up some extra arrows. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Just waking up. Probably take a couple of breaks before I get steadily sitting at the desk. Having my first cup of kava. Head over to the Ferocious Red Spider location and get set up. Forgot to do something. Yeah, I'm okay for now. has no one streaming that I like right now. Change out my pet whistle for an empty pet whistle. See, I'm still waking up. That's not where I'm supposed to be. The game's still stuttering when I get into the area with the spider. I'm gonna have to close the game client and restart it. Excuse me, morning coughs. looks okay. We'll see what happens when I fight those bears. Seems to be okay in here. Alright, so now I will I'll need to clear out the small spiders before focusing on my taming attempts of the large spider. I'm gonna do this so I don't have to worry about that light. The light will prevent me from using the hide skill. Turn brightness up so I don't have to worry about it. Spiders in the way right now. Thank you. my weapon away for a minute or so, build my stuff back up. Reminds me on my agenda is to increase my health and focus pools. I'll be doing that once I tame the spider. Or whichever comes first. Taming the spider, and once I level these up, start leveling these up, I can knock one out and add another one in there, and I'll work on the health and focus pools. Basically getting all these working getting these passives up to skill level 50. To turn around. Not taming her yet. I want to get this last egg. Without aggroing the ferocious spider. Clear up these webs. They'll keep respawning. I need to remember to keep clearing them or I'll get caught in them. And wait for the ferocious spider to turn around. Taking the time, continually trying to watch. Seeing who else is streaming on my list. I'm gonna have to reset it now. Basically, my goal for this run is to find out what is skill level 1. I mean, a 1% chance on this ferocious spider. I'm really hoping it's 100. I only have one. I'm at level 99. Really hoping at level 100 I'll get that 1%. And then I'll start working on knocking her down below her 50% health and trying to tame her. Because as soon as I get that 1%, knocking her down to 50 gives me an 11%, and so on. The more I get skill level, it will be 12%, 13%, so on. Do her little dance, turn around. Started out with much more experience. I started out with 400,000, expecting it to take a lot more experience to get each level in taming. So, depending on what happens, low on collars or 50% of my bar used is when I'll stop and go back and get more resources and filling up the pool again. Oops, wasted that. Now I have to wait longer. Gotta wait for that timer to clear, because every time I clear this net, it breaks my stealth, which is a little ridiculous. You should be able to do stealthy things. Matter of fact, I'm gonna make a post about that. Alright, stealth skills are too weak. You break stealth every time you interact with something. You should be able to interact with objects while in stealth, just like in most other games with sneaky characters. As long as I do not instigate a fight or get damaged, I should stay in stealth. And stealth should be a skill with no timer. It should only have a stealth meter for probability of detection. Something to it. Otherwise, this skill tree is nearly pointless for anything other than roleplay, which is pointless to most players. I mean, role playing is nice, but you get no game progression for role playing. Turn around. While waiting for her to reposition, checking. Awesome. One of my favorite Fallout 4 streamers will be starting within the hour. At least now she'll turn around.
Just let me lay out. Just let me lay out.
brainstorming about more details about the stealth stuff while I do this. Continuing with this post. Where did I start here? Okay, the stealth meter should have a staging effect where you have a base detection chance, then a bonus to not being detected based on skill level. Any different base level of detection when interacting with objects, including pickpocketing, which would make it more probable for detection, but still be able to be not detected based on skill level of pickpocketing and a skill for stealing or interacting while stealth. Halfway there. I know I've interrupted my progress by making those posts, but needs to be done. Those posts need to be made. With her moving quite a bit more than what she used to, makes things a little bit slower in here as well. Around a whole lot more now. Thank you. have something else to post? I'd like them to eventually add the possibility for us to purchase additional character slots, but I would like them to create a unique single character slot that you could have a separate character that has permadeath, like hardcore gameplay. Them changing her movement like she does to where she is, her back is to you less often in this area, that I dislike greatly, because that's nothing, that's just another time sink. Having her move around more often, I like. It makes things more dangerous, but to fix it so that it you have less taming attempts because of it, that's just, it's a timing. That's just, all that does is take you more time to do shit. Seriously. They need to fix this damn fucking... these timers.
Oh, so close to 100.
Burning up on those experience, 110,000 already used.
Thank you.
Grandmaster. I wonder if it'll keep leveling. Or if there's a quest I need to do. Still less than 1%. That fucking sucks. And yes, it continues to level. Potentially means I need 20 more levels to have a 1% chance to tame this fucking thing. Check the taming website to see if there's been any updates, information. New information.
She feels amazing, even though she looks completely dead.
No new information at all. Okay. Well, I'm gonna start doing this. Start leveling those as well. It's going to burn more experience, but now that I know I have potentially 20 more levels to go, it's going to take a lot longer anyway. I'm going to knock her down to 50% this time. Oh no. Game froze. What the fuck? Thank you. Less than 1% chance. Shit! Take a minute to see if I can search on the internet for something.
Thank you.
Well, of course, the devs wouldn't give me any secrets, which really disappoints me and makes me understand they have a false sense of secrecy, because this is game testing. Why not let us know what the specific mechanics are for game testing? I'm gonna go try to change. There's something. Supposedly the Corpions are better now, but I don't know. Corpion, which is this game's version of a scorpion. I'll go tame a couple of those and see how those work in fights. That's annoying. So I guess I'll keep doing this till I get to at least level 101 and not 50%, and then go back and leveling skills and refilling up my experience bar, but I'll also go find some Corpions. Maybe not. Wow. Maybe I need to go fill up the experience pool now. use that out of the 30,000, bring me down to 150,000. I'll keep 150,000 and then go fight stuff. Shouldn't take too many tries to get it, use up that experience. Something screwy with this timer. That's the second time it hasn't been ready when I've run up and wasn't in stealth. Approximately 6,000 experience now every time I make an attempt, because I have those other skills also leveling. Last try, well, last skill up first, taming right here. Alright, now I'm gonna kill her. Now I'm just gonna kill her. How was that possible? That was a bug. She shouldn't have been able to jump like that. Unless it's a new thing. See if we get any obsidians. None. It's still basic fucking crappy loot. They need to fix that fucking shit. Makes me angry that they're not dropping, but they're in the store. You can buy them. Alright. Off to find Corpions. I'm gonna get out of the zone and then search on the wiki to see where the stronger ones are, if there are any. Son of a bitch, get out of there. Well, stuttering there on the game. There's something called a ghost corpion, but it's intended for a multiplayer fight. Okay, there is something called a large scorpion. Okay, and I know where to get one. Along with the ghost scorpion, but it's tier 3. What the fuck? Doesn't make any sense. I mean, seriously? The difficulty is only tier 3? Okay, this is where I'm headed. Worm Sands area. I'm gonna get some coffee before I go in there. And it is 120 skill to get a 1% chance on the large red spider. But I'm gonna test this thing out with the Corpions. It's only a tier 3 area. I mean, that's ridiculous, I think. I mean, the large Corpion is so much easier to tame. I don't understand that. I guess it's just bugged right now as far as it being more powerful than the higher level creatures.